What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of our Building Top Gun Maverick Lego series here on the channel. I want to give a huge thanks to everybody who tuned in last week for episode one. It looks like a lot of you guys received this new series well, and we're pretty excited, so I want to thank you for that, obviously. If you guys haven't already, make sure you subscribe, drop a like down below, let me know what you think of the video throughout today's update. Now, this episode is going to be significantly shorter, but we actually got done a lot of progress, and you might be able to see some of that here behind me. Next week, actually, this video probably goes up on Monday or Tuesday. This week's going to be Brick World Chicago over at Schaumburg, Illinois. It's actually one of my first conventions when I first got into Lego, so I'm going to be away from Wednesday through Monday, which is pretty crazy. So this week's update is going to be a shorter video, but there's still a lot of progress to go over today. And real quick, while we're on the topic of Brick World Chicago, I'm super happy to announce I've partnered up with Whatnot to give away this $500 brand new condition OG Django minifigure. This is going to be happening on Whatnot on June 16th at 12 p.m. Eastern or 11 a.m. Central. We're giving this away completely for free. All you have to do is be there in my live show to enter for a chance to win. You guys can sign up with my link down below to get $15 off of your first purchase if you guys want to go in and have a chance to win this. We're also going to be doing lots of other fun stuff while we're at Chicago, and Whatnot itself is hosting a bunch of other amazing creators and sellers and shows throughout the entire convention, so make sure you guys are staying tuned. I figured since Brick World Chicago is coming up, and like I said, Chicago was my first convention ever, I wanted to do something big, you know, do a big giveaway for one of arguably probably one of the most rare and expensive Lego Star Wars minifigures as a little thank you to you guys for the couple of years we've been on this crazy journey. So yeah, make sure you guys tune out again June 16th, 12 p.m. Eastern time. Sign up with my link down below. So after today's video and the progress we're going to go over, I'm happy to say we're at least well over halfway done with this project, which is nice. I have decided to make this mock 2 gray base plates by 4. I know last week I debated on a couple of dimension options, but just with the time restraints and all that kind of stuff, we're going with a 2x4, which should still be plenty of room to do what I want to do and hopefully have it look super sick. I do want to give a huge thanks to my friend Jack or Hydrave. He's also a Lego builder in the community. He came down last weekend to help me with some fun stuff that I'm not too great with, including some rocks and all that little fun stuff. So huge thanks to Jack. We're going to be going over all the progress in today's video. So if you guys are excited, drop a like down below, subscribe so you don't miss any of the updates, and let's go ahead and get into the video. All right, so for the first part of this video, we have my camera mounts on the tripod. So I want to give you guys a quick overview of what this is looking like. Like I mentioned before, we did decide to go with the 2x4 gray base plate layout, but as you can see here, there's still plenty of room for this mock, for all the pieces and all the things that we want to include. We did go with this layout just because, again, for time constraints and stuff like that, but I think we're still going to be able to do a very, very good job. Now, first things first, you'll notice that the entirety of the river is actually tiled off. This was the part I was not looking forward to the most, I guess, or part I was least looking forward to, just because of the tedious nature of building and all that kind of stuff. Basically, there's a whole layer of 1x2 transparent plate, and then on top, there's 1x2 transparent tile. So imagine tiling 3.5x4 gray base plates with just 1x2 plate. It does take a while. Now, there are some parts I do want to go back and revisit. Like, for instance, you can see here the tiles don't line up right here, which just kind of looks a little odd. So I'm going to go in and obviously fix that stuff when I can. Nothing too crazy, but that was the main point of this next update. I wanted to say this is like my main goal of finishing the entire river. Now, I did actually go ahead and outline the shore, which came out pretty nice. I'm going to go ahead and move the jet real fast here, but basically just using a bunch of wedge plates, a bunch of plates and tiles and all that kind of stuff to make the shoreline. I'm not the best at making shorelines for like rivers and oceans and stuff like that, but I do like how this came out. I did try to incorporate a lot of different pieces, at least the pieces that I had in bulk that would make it a little easier for us to create with. So that pretty much spans the entirety of the river right here. And then of course we have the one section where we actually completely built out the snow and the rest of the trees. So let's go and take a look at that. Okay, so this right here is about a quarter of the snow section areas. Again, this is basically one gray base plate. There's another one here and then two down here on the left side. So what I wanted to do was just kind of get a good idea, a good sense of what this would look like. Obviously, if I need to make any changes or anything like that, now would be the time to prototype what I wanted to do and then make those changes going throughout. Now, the only thing that I would say kind of stumped me was actually the trees, no pun intended. I actually did not anticipate on building as many trees as I wanted to. In fact, you can see here, this back section is still not tiled off with snow. So there's gonna be maybe one or two more trees here, which brings the total trees for this one quarter of the mock to about 16 to 17 trees, which is a lot. And I have enough to maybe last for the next half or next third portion of the mock. So I think maybe in the next video, we're gonna have to go ahead and make some more trees. But I really love how this looks, especially with the lighting. Someone pointed this out in, I think it was my Instagram post or maybe even in the YouTube video last week, but with the lighting that I have, it looks like the trees are actually like covered in snow, which is nice. Now, I'm not going to be adding white pieces onto the leaves to simulate the snow. I don't think that's necessary. It'll also just look a little too blocky for my taste, but with the lighting here, it kind of looks like it's already covered in snow, which is super, super nice. But yeah, I think all these trees coming together, they look super, super nice. I think it's going to really look cool once the whole entire thing here is done, which should look super sweet. Building terrain has never been like my strong suit when it comes to building mocks, but I think this gets the job done. And especially when there's so many trees, you can't even really see details beyond like the first couple of studs, like towards the shore. So I think once we cover this entire section with all the trees, all the stuff like that, it should look really, really sweet. Now, it's also been super clutch because we have a lot of these 16 by 16 plates, and these are super helpful when it comes to elevating the mock to a different level. Instead of having to do multiple miniature, you know, 4x4 plates or 4x6, we just have a couple of these 16 by 16s, and then, you know, we're kind of raised already at the level that we want to be, which is nice. And then I just cover this with white tile plate, all that kind of stuff. So these have been coming in super, super clutch. So there's a lot of hours that went into the mock for this update. I'd probably say anywhere between 10 to 12 hours of work, basically just tiling off the rest of this, making the shoreline, and then obviously building the first semblance of the snow and the landscape that we have. But super happy with how the mock's turning out so far. This is a great pause point for the episode, but we're going to basically be continuing this all throughout the rest of the mock, and then hopefully we'll be done in the next couple of episodes. So yeah, let me know what you guys think down below, and let's go ahead and head to the outro of today's video.
So guys, that wraps up today's episode for the mock series. Hope you all enjoyed. I tried to get a lot of progress done. I've been working on the mock for probably about 2 weeks now. I think the most tedious part of it being the rivers, you know, that area with the dark trans tile, all that kind of stuff. That's the most tedious, but now that it's over, it's kind of like refreshing. I do also want to quickly mention, I know someone pointed this out, the actual fighter jet that I have is technically not accurate to the scene I'm building. So if you guys can see right here, those are all a bunch of parts that we're actually using to build a whole nother jet. I might make that into its own, you know, series update. I'm not sure. I have a review and a build like time lapse of the F-18 on my channel, so if you guys want to go ahead and check that out, you certainly can. But I do have another jet, we're going to be building that, so obviously it's a little more accurate to the specific scene that we're displaying. But I think in terms of for the next update, it's probably going to be about 2, 3, maybe 4 weeks until the next update. Most of the mock done. At this point, it's basically just making a couple of more trees just to fill in the area, and obviously tiling and plating the rest of the snow in the environment and stuff like that. I'm really loving how the trees are coming together. Obviously, I'm not detailing the terrain too much. It's just basic tile and plate and some wedge plates and stuff like that. But when you have all the trees sort of like really condensed in close proximity to each other, I think it gives off a really, really nice aesthetic, and I'm super happy with just how it's turning out. So yeah, hopefully within the next month we'll get out the final episode of the build series. I know again this is a mini shorter series, but yeah, nonetheless still having a great time with the project, and hope you guys are having fun watching the videos. That's pretty much all we got for today, guys. Hope you all enjoyed. Once again, if you guys want a chance to win this $500 OG Classic Django, go ahead and sign up for my Whatnot June 16th on Friday at 11 a.m. Central or 12 p.m. Eastern Time. Completely free giveaway. Huge thanks to Whatnot for sponsoring us with that giveaway while we're at BrickWiz Chicago. Make sure you guys are following me on my Instagram as well. I'm going to be posting a lot of content from Chicago on my story, all the fun stuff. And if you guys are, of course, in the area for BrickWiz Chicago, make sure y'all come out. It's going to be a great time. You get to meet so many other creators and builders and just personalities while you're at these shows. They're super fun. So definitely would urge you guys to come along. But that's all we got for today, guys. Hope you all enjoyed. Drop a like and let me know what you thought of today's episode, and I will see you guys later. Take it easy. Peace.